I live in New York City, and it's the place I know, and it's the place that inspires me. Everything happens in New York, and the people are fascinating, and people come to New York from all over the world to discover their fates, to discover their life, and they bring with them a great deal of passion, desire, greed, ambition. And things tend to happen to people when they come to New York City. And if you're a writer, you can find some very good stories. I began with the idea of one of the characters looking through the window and seeing the two characters in a bedroom across the way. And I realized that the woman had gone to extraordinary risks to do this. She's in an apartment that she and her husband live in, and I was curious to know why she had done this. What would make her do this? And the answer is very complicated. And I think that those triangles between men and women are very interesting and complex, and this one is particularly dramatic and dangerous, and I knew that if I kept pulling on that dynamic, a good story would come out of it. Why did I choose the main character to be a map collector? The answer is that I didn't really choose. It chose me. One of the reasons it took me so long to write the book is that I myself am a map collector, and I spent a couple of years passionately, crazily, collecting maps and learning a lot of the things that I put in the book. And I think maps are interesting, and I wanted to have a character who was obsessed with a particular map. And there's an old expression in writing fiction: you must make your characters want something, if only a glass of water. And this man wants a very particular, very important, very valuable map, and he's willing to do something that he shouldn't do in order to get it. So he gets mixed into this love triangle, and he wants this map, and things are going to happen as a result of it.